in terms of what my central research is about trying to understand the impact of race in the 21st century. It's complicated because the issue of race has become extremely complicated. We have the impact of 60 years in which African Americans and people of color more generally have been incorporated into the political system. And so that has had an impact in the ways in which people think about their identity as an American, the ways in which they think about what the American political system can do for them and has done for them, and where the American political system is going.
I want to put up a poll from UMass Amherst. It just came out earlier.
UMass poll has been in operation since 2010, and our goal is to provide comprehensive data on the health of the American democracy, the health of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And the hope is that this provides quality information, not just to policymakers, but to members of the mass public, whether those are citizens of the state of Massachusetts or citizens of the entire nation. And we're really committed to ensuring that the information that we are imparting is nonpartisan, it's non-ideological, it's really about trying to get a hold on the civic health and the civic future of our nation, our state. The story of race in America is that there are these peaks and these valleys. I don't know necessarily where we are right now. I do think that the election of the first woman person of color as vice president is another indication that the country has moved away from the notion that people of color can't inhabit these particular roles, right? And so I think that's a really important indication that we're moving forward. I think the recognition of the disproportionate treatment of African Americans by police, which has been occurring in the United States since the inception of the police force, is a good indication that people's eyes are opening to the treatment and the status of African Americans and people of color more generally. I think it's important to get people educated. That's part and parcel of what my job is about, is to educate, you know, young people about this issue of race and ethnicity and immigration and identity more generally, and to provide that information to them to help them chart solutions to these problems. I don't want my kids to live in the country I grew up in. And I don't think my kids want their kids to grow up in the country that they lived in. We want to improve, right? That is the thread that has gone through the United States since its founding. It's about improving itself.
Let's get right to it. And we'll start with the horse race that's in front of us.
We care about elections because they are the moment in time in which we as citizens of this country can influence the direction of our policies, influence the symbolism of who we, you know, put forward as the embodiment of our country. And what we're trying to ensure is that we provide that, again, nonpartisan, non-ideological, non-biased look at where politics are and where politics are going. This is not a Democratic poll or Republican poll or a liberal poll or a conservative poll. This is the UMass poll. Our hope is to be the go-to location for high-quality survey data and to provide that data that helps to make informed decisions, and educated conclusions about where we are and where we're going. You know, I have very lofty expectations and standards for my students. I want them to go change the world, and I tell them that on a regular basis.